title of today's lesson is basically, you know, to the fact is the creation of Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shah. And the reason why, you know, this lesson comes from the Spirit is because the Most High made everything beautiful. You know, everything that He made, you know, it was, you know, it is good. You know, everything He made is perfect. I made the Garden of Eden, and when you made everything in the Garden of Eden, everything was good, and it's very good. And when the kingdom of heaven be established, everything's gonna go back to its natural state, you know, which is perfection. You know, it's gonna be perfection in the kingdom of heaven, especially among the Israelites. You see, everything that the Most High made at the beginning, you know, is good and very good, and everything that He made has a purpose. And we have to understand that when Yahweh created everything, He created everything for a purpose, and everything had a balance. So when the Most High Yahweh created light, you know, He made darkness. When He created good, He created evil. You know, when He created man, He created woman. You know, when He created male, He created female. You know, everything has a balance, and everything was made perfect in the eyes of Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shah. You know, man, and, you know, fell off, you know, Adam fell off, and, you know, because of the serpent, and because the serpent tempted Eve in the garden, she took her the tree of knowledge of good and evil, and she ate the knowledge thereof, and she gave it to Adam. You know, which he did also eat. You know, the tree of knowledge of good and evil is the forbidden knowledge that the Most High, you know, didn't want us to have. That's why it was forbidden. You know, we didn't supposed to have it. We won't have it. And not forbidden tree, the knowledge of good and evil. And that knowledge is talking about diving to other philosophies that's outside the scripture. To get back to the point, you know, the Most High made everything perfect. You know, He made everything good. And, you know, we go back and we reflect in the scriptures when the Most High created the whole world. You know, He put the stars in this place. He put the He put the sun and moon in this place. He put all the galaxies in their place. You know, He put the seas in their place. You know, all the green grass and all that in its respective places. You know, everything's created. You know, perfect. When He created man, He created the animals and the fishes, you know, different types of species. You know, everything Yahweh created was, you know, through Yahweh Shah, man, in the hopeful land, everything He created was good and very good. You know, until man fell off, until Adam fell off, and caused sin to be into the world. And, you know, that comes to mind is Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 11. And it reads, He had made everything in His time. Also, He had set the world in their heart, so that no man can find out the work that Yahweh made from the beginning to the end. That's right, you know. The scripture also say that Yahweh know the end and from the beginning. You know that Yahweh made everything beautiful in his time. You know, when we get back into the kingdom of heaven, once the kingdom of heaven is established, you know, it's going to be beautiful in Yahweh's time. You know, Yahweh has a set day and time when everything is going to be back in the right place. You know, just like, you know, it was in the Garden of Eden, you know, everything gonna be made perfect. You know, everything's gonna be back in its originality, in its place. You know, we're gonna be learning righteousness. You know, we're not gonna be going off, you know, as being Israelites, because the scripture said that he made the world for our sakes. You know, he made the world for the sake of Israel. His chosen people, and we're going to go back to that state, that perfected state that Yahweh wanted us to be in the first place. You know, we're going to enjoy everything in its fullness. You know, the whole world in its fullness, the creation in its fullness. We're going to be able to, walk on grass and not worry about having, not worry about grass being prickly and anything else, and the trees are gonna be back in its natural state. The water's gonna be crystal clear. You know, everything is gonna go back to its normal state. You know, as Yahweh had it from the beginning. You know, once Esau Edom is taken out of power, the Most High is gonna restore everything back to its rightful place. You know, back and reflect in your mind and, you know, through the scriptures, and you sit back and meditate upon the scriptures, as it said in Joshua 1 and 8, you know, meditate upon the law, but, you know, get back to the point, is that, you sit back and you meditate on the scriptures, and just picture yourself in the scene that we have. Yahweh Shai, the angel of the host of heaven, made the whole world. You know, they made everything. Imagine how beautiful, how perfected it was. You know, back then, you know, everything was beautiful, perfected. The water was clear as crystal. You know, the fruit was delicious. You know, everything was organic. You know, with no sickness in the garden. Heart attack, no disease, none of that stuff. Everything, you know, was perfected, you know, back then. And then when King of Heaven gonna come, it's gonna be back, it's gonna be, everything will go back to its original state. You know, it's gonna be good.
Chapter 1 and
chapter 2. You know, meditate upon the Garden of Eden. Meditate upon the fullness on how Yahweh made everything. He made everything perfect. And just imagine, you know, He made everything perfect then. And then just imagine what the kingdom of heaven is going to be like. You know, if you read Revelation chapter 21 and chapter 22, it talks about the kingdom of heaven. It talks about New Jerusalem. We know it's a people before the place. But when you come down to it, you know, the streets going to be made, going to be paved with gold. Even in the book of Genesis, I think it was a place called Havilah. You know, a river called Havilah that was gold. You know, look, compared to similarities. You know, how everything that was in the Garden of Eden, everything in the book of Genesis talking about the Garden of Eden and compared to Revelation. You know, the streets are going to be paved with gold, the river life will be formed to clear as crystal. You know, everything gonna be beautiful, man. Jerusalem gonna be shining. You know, Israel gonna be shining. It's gonna be perfected by Yahweh, by Shem, Yahweh, Shah. You know, through the hope for that. And also, these other nations gonna be rebuilding everything. So, everything gonna go back to its normal state, just like it was in the beginning. And, you know, we got something to look forward to. You know, those who are Israelites, the Black, Latino, Native Americans. And also, you got the confusion of faces, which they forefathers go back to Israelites. You know, you are who your father is, you know, through the sperm. You are who your father is. You know, that's it for a lesson. You know, it's a very short, and quick lesson on the beginning. You know, we should look forward to the kingdom of heaven because the kingdom of heaven is near unto us. It's nearer than we expect. You know, those who have been Israelites, you know, for the whole for that, the 144,000, the 1/3, you know, got something to look forward to. And also to you wicked 2/3 out there, even though you're going to die on this side, you're going to be reborn in the kingdom of heaven and you're going to be able to enjoy the fullness thereof. Because the truth also said all of Israel is going to be together. You know, that's a beautiful thing. You know, that's it for a lesson. And all praise to the Most High, Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shah. Double up to the Apostle Elder, the Prophet, the Jewish, and the Seer, and True, to the Hopeful Elect, to the Archimedes, Alpha, now listen and learn. Until next time, Yahweh, Shalom.